It's taken us a really long time to get our hands on this all-new Tundra, but we've got the good one, so I suppose that makes up for it. This is the TRD Pro with the twin-turbo V6, and it's a hybrid. What's it like? Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things, and on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, this all-new Tundra, it's been a while since we've looked at it at the launch and the pre-launch. Didn't get to drive it way back when. It's taken a really, really long time to get behind the wheel. And here we are, and thankfully, we've got the good one, the TRD Pro. And before we get into what it's like to drive, let's have a look at it in a little more depth. Mechanically, we kind of know what's already going on here, but this is an all-new Tundra, and it definitely requires a little bit of examination from a mechanical standpoint. But for starters, it's a real truck. It's proper body on frame. After that, it is all-new Tundra. Powering this Tundra TRD Pro is the 3.5-liter twin-turbo V6 with the hybrid system, and combined, it makes 437 horsepower and a colossal 583 pounds of torque. The transmission's a 10-speed automatic. The four-wheel drive system is electronically controlled. There is a 2-speed transfer case. The limited slip diff in the rear is the electronically controlled type, which should be interesting. The steering is electrically assisted. The one thing worth noting is that the Tundra TRD Pro's steering rack is a little quicker than the others. Suspension's based around double wishbones at the front, multi-link at the rear, and then after that, it's all TRD Pro specific bits. For example, at the front, the dampers are the Fox internal bypass with remote reservoir type. The TRD Pro is about an inch taller than all the others. There are TRD Pro specific springs and a front anti-roll bar. There is load leveling rear suspension across all Tundras. Brakes are 13.9-inch front rotors with two piston calipers at the back, 13.5-inch rotors with single piston calipers. Wheels and tires are specific to this TRD Pro. It rocks 18s. As you can see, they're BBS forged with some 18-inch Falcon Wild Peak tires that are specific to this Tundra TRD Pro. Towing capacity of this one anyway is about 11,000 pounds, and curb weight is a tick over 6,000 pounds. With respect to this cockpit, gotta remember this is a full-size truck, so that changes things. People use trucks in different ways than they do other vehicles, especially sports cars, but this is no sports car. The seat is relatively flat, but it is very, very supportive. In this trim, it's heated and cooled, and it's got a limited amount of adjustment. It's also very, very big, so if you're on the larger side, you're gonna be very comfortable in this thing. But lots of adjustment in the seat and the steering column, and I'm set up perfectly here to interface with the truck. There's a dead pedal for my left foot, and everything is perfect in terms of my driver interface. After that, however, we've got a modern Toyota set of ergonomics. It is very, very tech forward, but on the other hand, a lot of the ergonomics are very simple. A lot of the switches, buttons, dials, very, very simple. With the infotainment system, however, all we have is a volume dial, and if we want to change the station, well, we've got to press the button. Speaking of which, this screen is so large that if I need to reach something on the other side of the screen, I actually have to kind of reach over to tap the button or whatever the case is. It's just an enormous screen, great for your passenger perhaps, but for me, I really don't want to lean all the way over to the other side of the screen. What I do like is that a lot of the secondary controls are just big switches, like the climate control, for example, very easy to deal with. The drive mode, as well as there's a tow mode button and other things going on, especially for off-roading, you can access everything here. It's pretty easy to deal with. And then the switch for the electronic transfer case is right here. It's all within reach, easy to live with. And of course, I have to mention the tow mode, not that we're hauling in this episode, but this new Tundra does all kinds of towing trickery so that if you are towing, you've got an extra layer of safety when you're towing a big trailer. Now, in terms of visibility, you're seated high off the road, and as you know, this thing is an inch taller than regular Tundras, which makes it even more difficult for me to climb up into the seat because I have short legs. Nonetheless, when you're sitting here, you can see all around almost 360 degrees. Of course, it does have cameras to help you park this thing or even off-roading, but I really like this seating position. You're seated high off the road, can see everything. With respect to spaciousness, well, that's what this whole cab is about. There's a ton of room here. Four other passengers are going to be very comfortable in this cab. The one thing I do have to mention is the battery pack, and I think some other things for the hybrid system are fitted underneath the rear seat. So if there is storage in the non-hybrid models, there is absolutely none of it here. As for the infotainment system itself, it's okay. I mean, I'm not quite sure why Toyota would go with a bespoke interface for this and a bespoke infotainment system. I use it on CarPlay and it works great for me. It is wireless CarPlay as well, which is very cool. There's a wireless charger here. And of course, if you want to plug in your phone with a wired connection, you can do that as well in a couple of different places. One of the highlights when you're sitting here is the digital instrument cluster of this TRD Pro. Everything's laid out clearly. You've got all the information you need. No trouble seeing any of the information here, even in direct sunlight. Toyota's done a very good job with that instrument cluster. One of the cool things that Toyota's done really, really well is keeping it very quiet here in the cabin. They've done a great job of eliminating wind noise and road noise, and oftentimes you can actually hear the turbos working. Yeah, this is the thing with the combined power output of this thing, almost 600 pounds of torque. This is ridiculously quick for a 6,000 pound truck. No problem at all. However, I've had a little bit of wheel spin in two-wheel drive, and I would have thought that the limited slip diff would have caught that, but it actually didn't. Otherwise, when we're on the go and I've driven it in a bit of deep snow and some mud, the traction just in two-wheel drive is impressive. There's not a lot of snow on the ground right now, so I haven't fully tested the four-wheel drive system, perhaps another time. But in terms of putting down this power and all that torque, it doesn't seem to be a problem for this truck at all. As you know, it's got a 10-speed automatic, and that just kind of really doesn't figure into the equation when you're driving, because it is so seamless in terms of the way this drivetrain operates. The transmission doesn't interfere, it doesn't get in the way, it shifts smoothly, quietly. I rarely can tell when it's actually shifting. Yes, putting it in sport mode does change the shift algorithm, and the performance really doesn't change all of that much because there is such an abundance of torque all the time. Speaking of torque, that's really what dominates the driving experience, is this abundance of torque. And that's what everybody loves. It's available from very low RPM through the mid-range, which is where you're gonna do most of your driving anyway. So the abundance of torque really helps. And perhaps that's what helps me get some decent mileage. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But I really love this abundance of torque, almost 600 pounds. Of it. Gotta love it. And since this is a modern Toyota, it does have some advanced driver assist, because this is one of the top trims for the new Tundra. So it does have adaptive cruise control, does have lane keep. It is Toyota style, which is safety first. So it does leave a lot of following distance between you and the car that you're following. One of the things I do dig about what they've done with this new Tundra is that they've got a quicker steering rack in the TRD Pro. It's slightly quicker, but that is appropriate for the most enthusiast-oriented Tundra model, that's for sure. That said, still has a massive turning radius. This is one big truck, and it takes three-point turns in a lot of instances. I have only been driving it in the city, and it is a big vehicle there. When you're on the open road like we are here, you're going to be very comfortable. And when it comes to turning this thing, steering is relatively accurate. It is very lightly weighted. There's not a lot of feel or feedback that comes through this steering wheel. And here we've got a tight corner. It's going to take a bit of turning to round this 90 degree corner, but it's just fine. And oh yeah, listen to the exhaust. I don't know if that's coming through. Even though this is a V6 with turbos on it, they've tuned this truck, and I think there's a little sound augmentation going on, but they've tuned it to make it sound quite good. Braking is simply excellent. Lot of confidence on this brake pedal. Very clear modulation and a decent amount of feel through that pedal as well. I think if you're towing this thing, you're going to feel like you've got an abundance of braking capacity. I mean, this thing will tow almost 11,000 pounds, but the brakes seem up to the task. in terms of handling, this is a big truck, so it really is about the ride and handling equation here. In terms of handling, we know this is the TRD Pro, and it is the off-road oriented one. This is not as softly suspended as perhaps a Raptor would be, or whatever they make over at Ram, but this is a decent all-around combination. You can still tow properly with this truck. What I do find, it is a little firmly suspended, and that of course has to do with the type of suspension calibration that they want. So they want this to be good all around rather than being able to softly soak up some off-road bumps. So it is capable of off-roading, and I'm really enjoying it on some rougher surfaces, but it's just a little on the firm side. On smooth roads, of course, it's brilliant. This bit of road is just terrible, but what we do have is excellent body and wheel control. Feels like the tires are always in contact with the road, and the Fox dampers are doing a great job of controlling body movement as well. Even over larger imperfections or some speed bumps that I've hit, this thing does soak them up, just not as softly as, say, a Raptor would, for example. Overall, ride and handling is pretty decent. Again, a little on the firm side over bumpy roads like this, but you and your passengers are going to ride along in comfort until the roads get really bumpy, and this thing seems like it's capable of going off-roading. I'd love to be able to do that, but this isn't the season in this part of the world to make that happen at the moment. Perhaps we'll do that in the summer.
How do you spec yours? Well, this is really easy because this is the only Tundra I would get, the TRD Pro, for reasons we've already discussed. Price of this TRD Pro as tested in the United States is about $69,000. Here in Canada, it's $86,000. And in terms of speccing yours, there's only one thing you need to do, and that's to pick your color, just not this boring gray that they love to sell here in Canada. My verdict, well, let's start with fuel consumption, and combined I'm getting about 15 miles per gallon, or about 15 liters per 100 kilometers for my Canadian friends. That's actually not too bad. The last time I drove a full-size pickup, I was probably doing 12 miles per gallon with this kind of driving, which is mixed highway and city. And at 15 miles per gallon, I'm kind of impressed with myself, and regular viewers of the show know that I drive for pleasure, not to chase fuel consumption numbers. That said, what do I think about this truck? Well, I really dig it. It's probably the first truck I've really enjoyed since my Titan XD with the Cummins diesel years and years ago. And this thing I really dig. I'd like to spend a lot more time with it to understand the benefits of the hybrid system, because I think I can probably get more fuel mileage out of this thing. Not that I really care about that, but otherwise, love the TRD Pro specification for all the fun stuff that it brings to the Tundra. As for this all-new Tundra, well, I think it's on point for 2023. It's got the right amount of ruggedness, it's got the right amount of tech as well to be a proper full-size truck competitor in this very, very competitive truck market.
Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this all-new 2023 Toyota Tundra TRD Pro. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch, and Toyota is still making awesome manuals, so props to Toyota. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you again next time, and remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even full-size Toyota Tundra pickups.